made the world your stage. You wanted the attention. Now you got it.
Hi, everybody. So today we're going to talk about the great limited series, The People Vs. OJ. And of course, Ryan Murphy was the showrunner for that show. And I was just blessed to be a part of such an incredible cast. And I'm going to talk about two scenes. So the first scene I'm going to talk about is with Johnny Cochran and Dale Cochran. Now, I played Dale Cochran, of course, and so a little bit about that. Ryan didn't want us to talk to the real people while we were shooting the show because you don't want to get influenced by others' opinions when we're doing one particular show and one particular view on this story. And so I really wanted to meet Dale. So I had to do a lot of the research to find out something about her. And when I did research, what I found was very little, which told me a lot about her. They're in this time of social media and people wanting to get their limelight and all those kinds of things. She isn't that kind of person, which told me about her. She was a person who was quiet, who was behind the scenes, who was the strength for her husband. And also this kind of power that you hold without having to tell anyone about it. So that told me a lot about her. So that was, I just researched as much as I could. I didn't get a lot, so I had to go on what I had. So you'll see in this first scene, the strength she has and the power she had to help her husband during this difficult trial. And of course, I played opposite the great Courtney Vance. Amazing. He was Johnny. He looked like him. He was Johnny. He did such an incredible job. So here's his first scene. Let me know what you think.
It's about an obsession to win at any cost. And we are confident that the evidence will reveal that the LAPD is a blunders in blue operation. No.
No, it sounds like you're trying to be funny.
Baby, I'm not trying to be funny.
But that's what it sounds like, honey.
Okay.
You can do it. Go
on. All right, let me try. Hold on. We will reveal that the evidence collected by the LAPD was contaminated, compromised, and corrupted.
Oh, baby.
That is it.
That's it. That is it.
Nice alliteration.
Mm-hmm.
Three C's.
It has a flow, honey. It's perfect. You got it. I'm glad you're on this.
It's like it's my destiny, baby.
Well, destiny has a powerful attraction.
What you doing?
I closed my book.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
What you doing?
Take it off my rope.
No. You bringing it to me?
Let her, brother.
Uh-oh.
I'm trying to bring you it. That bad phone didn't ring.
It did ring. Go ahead, answer it. Be quick.
Good evening, Johnny Cochran.
We have a problem.
What time is it?
Are you still at work?
You're kidding.
All right. Go ahead. What you got?
Shapiro's staff messed up and didn't submit 12 of our witnesses into discovery.
Really?
You're going to have to remove those names
out of your opening statement tomorrow, Johnny. I'm sorry to do this to you.
I'm not removing those names, brother.
What? No, Johnny, we can't do that.
Here's the thing, Carl. There comes a time when you got to fall on your sword for your client. Tomorrow is your day.
Okay, so now we're going to talk about the scene that I get asked a lot about. It's a short scene, but it made such a strong impression for people that watched it. And I think it was because this was the first time you were seeing Johnny show vulnerability. And that's the only time you see it is when he's with his wife in the series. And I think it's important that you see that he was a person that dealt with all the things we deal with. It's just, so I love that they were showing it through his wife in their relationship. What I'll tell you about behind the scenes with this one is that Anthony Hemingway, who's a great director, a great person, I love him, we decided to shoot this scene in a few different ways. So there was this one that we did where she was angry. She was fuming, and she was going off on him in this anger. And we took that. Then we did it another way. What would it be like? Let's do it in a way that she's constrained in her anger, in her... It's more on the side. Sometimes when we're so angry, you don't see the hurt. But what if it's hurt? What if it's... We're seeing it in that, the hurt instead of the anger. And so we did a take with that. And so we did another take and another take. So I loved being able to portray her in so many different ways. And you never know what they're going to take. So when I saw the show is when I knew which one they took. And so the one that they took was the one that she was hurt. And I think that was a better take in terms of really hearing it. Sometimes we can watch someone be angry, but really hearing it and feeling the hurt that she was going through. So here we go. Watch this scene.
I'm going to find out how he did it. And when I do, it's going to be hell to pay. But it was him.
So it was Bob Shapiro who made you live a double life while you were married with Barbara.
I shut the press right down today, baby. You'll never hear another word about it. I handled it. Maybe you knew all that about when we got married.
Yeah, I knew it, Johnny. But my friends didn't. My family didn't. My pastor didn't, Johnny.
I'll find out what happened. I'll find out who did this.
Nobody did this. There is no conspiracy, Johnny. You cannot fix it. Unless you have a time machine I don't know anything about. All your stuff with Barbara, all of it is in court records, Johnny. You made the world your stage. You wanted the attention. Now you got it. Now you got it.
So I hope you enjoyed a little behind the scenes from The People vs. OJ. If you have any questions, let me know. Any other things that I didn't cover with this particular series, I love to answer that. Again, this is Screen Stories with Keesha, and I hope to see you next week. Don't forget to subscribe and to follow. We'll see you soon. Bye.